class, we talked about atrial septal defect, ventricular septal defect, and PDA. So those are the osyanotic congenital heart diseases. In this, we will be talking about cyanotic and obstructive one, and you need to know in detail about tetralogy of Fallot and coarctation of aorta only. Classify the heart disease, we had classified as in three types, that is left to right shunt, that is osyanotic type, and this is the second one, that is right to left shunt. The topic you should know in detail is about tetralogy of Fallot and some thing about like tricuspid atresia, Ipsen anomaly, and TGA, transposition of great vessels. You should know what that means. So generally, by the name suggest tetralogy of Fallot, there are four anomalies in the hearts, and then patient will be presenting with cyanotic, but may not be immediately after the birth, after some time. So all the cyanotic heart diseases, though the defects are present at the time of the birth, might not present fully at the time of birth. So among the cyanotic heart diseases, TOF is the most common one, that is tetralogy of Fallot. So you have the four components. So main critical component of the tetralogy of Fallot is the narrowing of the pulmonary valve, that is pulmonary stenosis, and there is right ventricular hypertrophy, that is thickening of the right ventricular wall, and then there is presence of the VST, that is ventricular septum, and fourth is also called as displacement of the aorta or the overriding of the aorta over the ventricular septal defect. And it is given in the percentage. So VST unit, how vanda kati right ventricle tira aako cha, like 50% overriding or 75% overriding. If it is full overriding, that is fully the aorta may arise from the right ventricle. And that time it may be called as double outlet right ventricle. Tetralogy of Fallot with DORV. It is called as when the displacement of the aorta is 100% and there is no outlet from the left ventricle, aorta and the pulmonary artery both arises from the right ventricle, then that is called as double outlet right ventricle component of the tetralogy of the Fallot. And other three will be there. And in some book, if ASD is also present, then it is termed as pentalogy of Fallot. So among these four, if ASD is also there, then it is called as pentalogy of Fallot. But the pathophysiology and all the things are almost same. So physiologically, because of the pulmonary stenosis, even in the intrauterine life, right ventricle has to work against the pressure. So there will be right ventricular hypertrophy time of the birth itself. And because of the presence of the VST in the systole, when the right ventricle contracts, so instead of blood flowing through the narrow opening of the pulmonary valve, the blood will go from the right ventricle to the left ventricle. So there will be right to left shunt, because the deoxygenated blood will be going to the oxygenated side, your patient will have cyanosis. So this is the main problem in the tetralogy of Fallot. And during systole, there will be no blood flow towards the pulmonary circulation. So pulmonary circulation will be getting less blood in case of the cyanotic heart diseases. So in AST, VST, you had pulmonary circulation getting lots of blood and the patient having frequent pneumonia. But in tetralogy of Fallot, the pulmonary circulation will be getting less amount of the blood. And severe the pulmonary stenosis, less the blood goes towards the pulmonary side and less the oxygenation and more the cyanosis will be. So severity of the tetralogy of Fallot is determined by the severity of the pulmonary valve narrowing. So pulmonary stenosis, jati saro cha, teti nilo, ra teti saro hune ho. Other components are accessories like overriding of the aorta, thickening of the right ventricle and VST. So clinically, you hear only ejection systolic murmur when you examine the patient of the tetralogy of Fallot. Because of the VST, the two ventricles work as a same chamber, and so pressure will be identical. So since the pressure is identical, when the blood flows from the right ventricle to the left ventricle, you will not hear the pan-systolic murmur as in the isolated VSD. So VSD matre bhako case ma asti padhe jasto jasto pan-systolic murmur sunincha ani isma aba dherai component sanga VSD associated cha, you know, tetralogy of Fallot ma chai you will not hear a pan-systolic murmur. So there will be only pulmonary stenosis giving the ejection systolic murmur. And if the VSD is small also, there will not be murmur. So delayed and soft P2 will be there. Since the pulmonary valve will be closing later than the aortic valve because of the narrowing of the pulmonary valve and then slow blood flow, there will be delayed and the soft P2 in the tetralogy of Fallot. But clinically, we might not determine the delaying and the softness of the second heart sound and A2, P2, but still, you should be able to see the ejection systolic murmur. So if you see a child with ejection systolic murmur and a cyanosis, then suspect tetralogy of Fallot. And when you examine, you might find clubbing. So cyanotic congenital heart disease, if standing for a long time, gives you the clubbing. So those features are there in case of cyanotic heart diseases, clubbing and cyanosis. So in case of tetralogy of Fallot, contradictory to the cyanotic heart diseases, CCF doesn't occur commonly. So congestive cardiac failure, jun AST, VST are ma common cha. Tetralogy of Fallot ma chai teti common chaina. But exceptions are severe anemia when your hemoglobin is low. Usually in cyanotic heart diseases, there will be polycythemia because of the hypoxic stimulation as the tissue level. So tissue level ma chai ramro oxygenation hudaina, and it will stimulate the erythropoietin production and more of the hemoglobin will be released in the circulation. So usually you have polycythemia. But if at all it is associated with severe pneumonia, then the child can go into heart failure. If infective endocarditis occurs, or if there is development of systemic hypertension, AR or PR, or development of myocarditis. So if these five factors are there only, child can go into CCF. Otherwise, tetralogy of Fallot, patient will not be having congestive cardiac failure as a complication. So usually symptoms appear anytime after the birth. So there will be blue child and there will be dyspnea on exertion, like along with the heart diseases. They will also have a feeding problem. Suck rest, sucks, rest will be more and sucking time will be less. And common symptom, anoxic spell. So whenever the child cries or urinates or immediately after waking up or runs around, then there can be increase in the blood and then loss of consciousness. And sometimes generalized tonic-clonic seizure can also occur. So because of the hypoxia. So these spells are called as anoxic spell. What happens whenever there is straining or whenever the child cries, our right-sided pressure increases. So because of the increase in the pulmonary pressure, the blood flow through the pulmonary valve, which is already stenotic, decreases. So there will be one cycle where there will be no blood flow through the pulmonary circulation. So that's when you get the anoxic spell. So your deoxygenated hemoglobin will be more and there will be hypoxia, patient will faint, and then they might have seizure sometime. So anoxic spells, if occurs frequently, then it is the sign that the tetralogy of Fallot needs urgent surgical management. So there will be cyanosis, clubbing, and ejection systolic murmur when you examine the child. So investigation-wise, ECG will show the right ventricular hypertrophy type of ECG. In chest X-ray, you will see the normal-sized heart, but it will be boot-shaped, and long field will be oligamic. So oligamic is opposite of the plethoric long field that you see in the AST, BSD, and PDA. Oligamia means there will be no blood flow in the lung, and then you will have a lung that looks like almost like pneumothorax. that is no blood vessels at all. So good separate heart, and sometimes there will be prominent left-sided aortic arch, since there will be blood will be going more from the left ventricle to the aorta, so aorta will also undergo the hypertrophy. So this is the given by the prominent left aortic arch, and this is given by the right atrium, and you can see there is the upturning of apex. So you, this looks like a boot. So boot separate heart with the oligemic lung field, that is no blood vessels in the lung, in a cyanotic child who have ejection systolic murmur, you can clinically diagnose even after, before the echocardiography, as a tetralogy of Fallot, possible tetralogy of Fallot. So definitive diagnosis is given by the echocardiography, where you can see all the four defects of the tetralogy of Fallot. So complications, CCF rarely occurs, but agi bhaneko jastai 5 wata kura chha bhane jani CCF huna sakcha. Otherwise, infective endocarditis can occur, but this is also rare. Anemia, polycythemia can occur. If the polycythemia is more, there can be thrombosis of the veins, especially of the cerebral veins, and then can cause anoxic infarction of the CNS, or it can dislodge from those veins and can cause embolus in the other vessels of the CNS. So anoxic infarction as well as embolic infarction, both are common in the patient of tetralogy of Fallot. And brain abscess are also common in the patient with tetralogy of Fallot. Like they can have a dislodgement of the embolus, and then later on that can get infected, causing the brain abscess. So if the child has all the features of tetralogy of Fallot along with the fever, headache, seizure, and certain neurological deficits like monoparesis or quadriparesis, then you can suspect brain abscess as a complication. If at all these complications are there, you have to manage them medically. The anemia might need blood transfusion to raise the hemoglobin as per the age of the child. And anoxic spells, that is, if the child falls blue and then stops respiring and then starts convulsing, when you examine, you immediately keep the child in knee chest position. That helps in lowering the right sided pressure by few millimeter of mercury, and then you would give oxygen to the child. And morphine also helps in relieving anxiety, as well as it is a selective pulmonary vasodilator. So myocardial infarction ma jastai tetralogy of Fallot ko anoxic spells ma pani pulmonary vasculature haru lai dilate garna kaam lagcha. So when you dilate the pulmonary vasculature, you decrease the right sided pressure, so the blood flow towards the pulmonary site can be slightly enhanced by the help of the morphine and knee chest position. So these two, if doesn't help, then you give the sodium bicarbonate, the 1 to 3 milliliter per kg as per the weight of the child, or propranolol. This both helps in the correction of the acidosis that the child is having. So even the minutes increases in the child having the anoxic spells, the more chances the child will go into the metabolic acidosis. That's why if you cannot correct it immediately with the knee chest position, oxygen and morphine, sodium bicarbonate can be given without doing the arterial blood gas analysis in the anoxic spells. Otherwise, if you could wait, child started respiring after giving morphine, you can do the blood gas analysis, and if the acidosis is there, then only you can supplement with the sodium bicarbonate. And propranolol also helps in vasodilation, and selective vasopressors on the systemic side can be also used to increase the left-sided pressure in the heart, so as to decrease the right to left shunt and then increase the pulmonary flow sometimes. And IV fluid if the child is unconscious. Whenever we cannot manage it medically, if the this apneic spell or the cyanotic spells are frequent, and then child have now anoxic seizures frequently, and also have this thromboembolic phenomenon, then it's better to go for surgical treatment. And surgical treatment are of two types, that is palliative. You just increase the pulmonary blood flow by shunting some of the systemic artery to the pulmonary artery. Usually, subclavian artery is shunted to the pulmonary artery, known as BT shunt or Blalock toxic shunt. So this is the most common type of shunt performed. And then port shunt, so where you join the descending aorta with the pulmonary artery. So these all will help blood flow towards the pulmonary artery bypassing the pulmonary valve, so that the blood will get oxygenated and then come back to the left ventricle for the systemic oxygenation. So if these fields like BT shunt you kept, and then the child grows and the shunt will not usually grow. So if these are only for the time being, you plan for the definitive procedure. So palliative surgeries, if you do, it is usually before the planning of the definitive surgery. And in definitive surgery, you close and repair all of the defect. Like VSD is repaired, and infundibulum is cut through, and you repair the pulmonary stenosis also, and you correct the overriding of the aorta, and then follow up echocardiography to see for the regression of the right ventricular hypertrophy. So all the three repairs are corrected definitively in the surgery. So now coming to the few names of the other cyanotic heart diseases, you should know only definitions in these. And so what is Epstein anomaly? Epstein anomaly, there is posterior valve of the tricuspid valve and the other valve, that is posterior anterior valve other than the septal leaflet, is shifted towards the ventricle. And you can also see the right atrium is large and the right ventricle. So right embryologically, the right ventricles reaches up to the here in the Epstein anomaly. So this is called as the atrialization of the ventricle. There is downward and the shifting of the valve, and these tricuspid valves will be hypoplastic or non-functional. So these whole chamber will be functioning as a one chamber. There will be presence of the patent foramen oval, through which the right atrium blood will flow towards the left atrium. So the shunting occurs at the level of the atrium. There will be intact ventricular septum, and there will be hypoplastic and downward shifting of the valve. And this causes the right atrium to enlarge hugely, and this replaces the enlarged right atrial shadow given by the heart on the chest X-ray. So you will get a box-like heart in case of Epstein anomaly. So Epstein anomaly is generally seen when the patient has taken lithium during the first trimester. Jun bipolar disorder, mania haruma lithium chalainchha, tele garda chai huncha bhancha, haina. So you should remember how Epstein anomaly is caused, what is it. Usually there is downward displacement of the hypoplastic valve, tricuspid valves. There is atrialization of the ventricular wall, and right atrium is used. And there is right to left shunt at the level of the atrium. So patient will be cyanotic. And now transposition of the great arteries. Usually aorta arises from the left ventricle, and then pulmonary artery from the right ventricle. When it is shifted, like aorta arises from the right ventricle and the pulmonary artery from the left ventricle, it is called as transposition of the great arteries. So D means this type in the photo. And if sometimes levo transposition of great arteries means there is switching of the ventricle as well. Now the left ventricles will also come here, and the right ventricle goes to that side. That is known as corrective TGA. Now at least the blood from the left atrium comes to left ventricle and then goes to the aorta, and that patient may be asymptomatic. So dextro TGA is the type where the patient will be symptomatic immediately after birth. There will be cyanosis. And if there is no communication between the atrial septum, ventricular septum, or the great arteries, patient will die immediately after the birth. So PDA, ASD, PSD, if among these three, one or two is there, then only patient will survive. So the heart is usually narrow here, the pedicle will not be seen, and egg on side appearance will be given in the oligemic lung field. So those are the examples of few cyanotic heart diseases you might encounter commonly. Tetralogy of Fallot you should know in detail. Now coming to the third category of the congenital heart diseases, these are not so common, and coarctation of aorta is the only one you need to know in detail. Aortic stenosis, pulmonary stenosis, usually not so common, occurs as a part of other defects like tetralogy of Fallot, Majun pulmonary stenosis huncha. Estu khalko ma chai dekhincha. Isolated pulmonary stenosis and isolated aortic stenosis is rare. And bicuspid aortic valve causing aortic stenosis is seen in Turner's syndrome. So coarctation, usually there is indentation in the wall of the aorta. So janira doctor's arteriosus huncha, tyo bhanda agadi pani huna sakcha, pachadi pani huna sakcha. So according to that, it is classified as pre-doctoral or post-doctoral. So pre-doctoral ones are more severe. They usually manifest at the neonatal or infant's life, that is within 12 months of life. And other type, that is adult type also, it is called as may manifested in the adulthood or the older children. So indentation of the anterior, lateral, and posterior wall. So medial wall is paired at the junction of the arch of aorta with the descending aorta. So embryologically, they both are formed from the different tubes. So if there is indentation at the joining, then it leaves the coarctation of the aorta. So it may be distal or proximal to the ductus arteriosus. So that's why it is called as pre-doctoral or infantile. Infantile, since it manifests within 12 months of life, or adult type. So it may go unnoticed because murmur will not be there, and then it may go unnoticed till the adulthood. So there will be no collateral formed and symptoms will be immediate. There will be like low blood pressure or in the lower limbs, weak femoral pulses, and hypertension in the upper limbs. So that is the typical clinical features seen in the coarct. So usually in older children, when they are walking, they might complain of pain in the calf, that is called as intermediate claudication. Means while walking, there will be pain, and when they will rest for some time, the pain will subside. So this is also seen in the peripheral arterial diseases like Buzzard's diseases. You might be taught later on in surgery. So usually walking, there is pain in the calf, and then when the child rests for 1 or 2 minutes, the pain subsides. So that is called as intermediate claudication. And there will be pain and weakness of the legs because of the ischemia. And there will be dyspnea on exertion. So because of the indentation, there will be less blood flow towards the descending aorta and the lower limbs and the other side. So there will be weak femoral or impalpable femoral pulse. And before the coarctation, that is, there will be presence of the subclavian artery. So it will give high blood pressure in the limb because of the high pressure in the pre-coarct area. So jahan coarct huncha, tyo bhanda agadi chai blood pressure badhcha. So these two are the internal carotid artery, and then there is this right subclavian artery. So especially the right-sided pressure will be high. And if the coarct is below the left subclavian artery, then also left subclavian pressure may be high. So you may have only high blood pressure in the right upper limb, and all three limbs will have low pressure. Or you may have high blood pressure in the both the upper limb and the low pressure in the both the lower limb, depending upon the where the coarctation is, whether the left subclavian artery is spared or not. So left subclavian artery yaha mathi bhayo bhane chai pressure badhne bhayo duitai upper limb ma left subclavian artery coarct bhanda tala chha coarct mathi bhayo bhane chai then you may have low BP in the left limb and the both the lower limb. Investigations are same in all heart diseases. You do ECG, chest X-ray, and then echocardiography. So because the left ventricle has to pump the blood against the narrowing of the aorta, there will be left ventricular hypertrophy. And then chest X-ray will have a normal size heart. Usually, there might be prominent ascending aorta and aortic knuckle. So in X-ray, you might see there can be aortic knuckle and prominent